So, right. So, we'll be starting today Sakul queries, parent to child, child to parent. How to write parent to child, child to parent Sakul queries. How to write parent to child, child to parent Sakul queries. How to get the data from based on the parent record, how do you get the child data? Based on the child record, how do you get the parent data? That's what we are trying to understand. So look at this. When do you say two objects are connected? When there is a lookup relation or a master detail. Only when there is a lookup or a master detail, I can say that both of them are connected. Only when there is a lookup relation or a master detail relation, then I can say both of them are connected. Let us say I have parent field 1.
Satish, we don't have audio, Satish.
Not audible? Other people, am I audible? Online people?
Yeah.
Yes, Satish. Yes, Satish, you are.
Yeah. Who is unable to hear? Right. Okay. Right, okay. Let us see now. Now, both the objects are here. Parent object and child object. I have parent field 1, parent field 2. Child field 1, child field 2. Both of them are connected by a lookup relation. Or it is connected by a parent. It is created by master detail. The question is, the question is, who created this relation? Guru Prasad, meet your mic. Meet your mic. The question is, who created the relation? Now let us assume it's a standard relation. Standard relation means Salesforce created this relation between the objects. Salesforce has created the relation between these two objects. Now look at the point. If the Salesforce has created the relation, list of parent, because we are getting parent data along with the corresponding child data. List of parent, result equal to select parent field 1. Parent field 2, select child field 1, child field 2 from childs, from, now this is a child object. What is the name of the object? Child. Parent. This is child. Now select parent field 1, parent field 2, select child field 1, child field 2 from childs, from parent. Select parent field 1, parent field 2, select child field 1, child field 2 from childs. We are appending s after the child object. We are appending s after the child object. From childs, from parent. Now, account and contact object is there. Who is a parent, who is a child? Account is a parent, contact is a child. Now, who created the relation between them? Salesforce has created the relation. Then how do you do it? List of account. account is equal to select name, phone, industry, select last name. This will be select parent fields, comma, select child fields from child from parent. Now let us take account and operation. List of account. Select name, amount, page name. From this we create select name, phone, industry, select name, amount, stage name from opportunities from account. Now why it is a standard relation? If the Salesforce has established the relation between two objects are created. The relation between two objects are created by the Salesforce. If the relation between two objects is created by the Salesforce, then select parent field 1, parent field 2, comma, select child field 1, child field 2 from child from parent. Is that was clear? Okay. Now write a quick example. I hope you are clear with this format. People are clear with this format. Okay. Now let us take this example. Write a query to fetch all the accounts with corresponding write a SQL query to fetch all the accounts with the corresponding contacts. Write a query to fetch all the accounts corresponding contacts whose write a query to fetch all the opportunities corresponding opportunity responding course. Complete the first two. list of accounts with the corresponding contacts. Same story. Where? One is. Select last name, first name from contacts where phone equal to 1234 from account. Write a query to fetch all the opportunities with the corresponding opportunity items. So look at this example, everybody. Opportunity with opportunity items. Go to opportunity. Choose any one of the existing opportunity. Now, they told opportunity amount of 2,35,000. How this amount is coming? Based on now opportunity of 2,35,000. What products are you selling? Unless I sell a product, you will not give me this amount. Now it is saying it's an opportunity of 2,35,000. Okay, what I was supposed to sell? He is going to give me an opportunity of 2,35,000 on what? He is interested to purchase a product one, product two. Which products he is interested to purchase? Am I right or no? If somebody is paying you money, you don't pay you at the free of cost. He is going to purchase some product or a service. Now, what you are purchasing? Look at this. On the opportunity we have, add product. I told you these are the products. Now, product 1, quantity 4. Product 2, quantity 4. When you want me to deliver? Now, this has given you opportunity of this. Now, these are what? Opportunity item. These three are contributing 4 lakhs, 5 lakhs, 5 lakh plus 9 lakhs. This is contributing to the amount of? Are you getting my point? So, this opportunity amount is coming based on these products. Now these are called as what? Opportunity line items. These line items together is joining together, giving an amount of source. Now the customer is interested to purchase 2 laptops, 2 mobile phones, 2 tabs. Together he is interested to purchase. Together is giving you some like 3 lakh rupees as a revenue. Are you getting? So what was this called? Opportunity line items. What we called as opportunity line item. So internally what is an object? It is also a standard object. Opportunity line item is also a standard object. Let me show you this. Create it. Select name, amount from comma. Select your price. Price. Then from opportunity line items from where I'll give the this particular record will take it because we entered the data. It will be easy for you to identify where ID equal to. So look at this opportunity name, opportunity amount, stage name. Opportunity name, opportunity amount, stage name. Then what we had here? Opportunity. Right. Unit price, list price, price book entry, product code. Opportunity with opportunity. Look at this, how you are getting. Now, to make it more clear for you, I'll also add a name. Now look at this. Product 1, product 2, product 3. All these are child of opportunities. Child of opportunity. Opportunity with opportunity line item. Now tell me, how do you write a query? List of opportunity. Select name, field price. Opportunity line item. This will be very useful query. This is very frequently used. Very frequently used query. Opportunity with opportunity item. How to enter the opportunity item? You are seeing this opportunity amount will come from opportunity line item. Okay, which products he has interested? This amount is coming based on which product? This product 4 quantity required. This product 3 quantity required. This product 2 quantity required. All of them together, it is an amount of 10 lakh rupees. Opportunity with opportunity line item. Opportunity with opportunity line item. The next one. People are good with this. Now, at the same time, let us go through this setup. Customize. Then we have opportunity. Quotation settings. Enable quotation. We have enabled a quotation. Now go to opportunity. Go to opportunity. If I go to opportunity, scroll down. What are you getting here? New quote. Testing status, subtotal discount, total price, I give some quote data, right? Quotation. This quotation is what? This quotation is what? Child of, this quotation is what? Child of opportunity. For opportunity we have quotation. For quotation, we have a quotation line items. Opportunity has a child of quotation. Quotation has quotation line item. Now, this quotation associated with opportunity and account. Now, let us see this. First, we will write a query to fetch quote data. This CRM wise, this relations are important for us. Now, a quick grand total, name, person ID, owner ID, phone number I don't need, price book entry, quote number, quote ID. I'm making a simple file. Quote number and tax. Now look at this. This is a quotation, this is a grand total. The quotation, this is a grand total of the quotation. This is the opportunity with which it's associated. Now, opportunity is the parent for quote. So based on the opportunity, I can get all the list of quote because I can create multiple quotes for the same opportunity. I can create multiple quotes for the same opportunity. Now, what is the data we are going to get? Look at the point. Quotation name. Opportunity, quotation number, total, grand total, name of the quotation for which opportunity. If you want, you can also give account ID for which contact ID. Right. This. The quotation is associated with which opportunity. This opportunity is associated with an account, contact, quotation number, tax, price, grand total. You get the fields? So we can make it simple. Name of the quotation, opportunity, then we're going to give you quotation number, tax, total price, grand total from quote. This is a child of opportunity. Now write a query to get all the opportunities with the corresponding quotations. Now write a SQL query to get all the opportunities along with the corresponding quotations. Write a SQL query to get all the opportunities with the corresponding quotations. Write a SQL query to get all the list of opportunities with the corresponding quotations. What is SQL query to fetch opportunity with the list of quotations? From up. Right? So I'll give some more. You can try it later. These are frequently used. Responding Okay, query to fetch. Account with corresponding contacts. Account with corresponding orders, contracts, assets. So practice these three examples also, right? Let us go to the next example. In this case, what we have done? Fetching the account with the corresponding sale records, contacts, opportunities, assets, order, okay, quotations. We are fetching this. Now let us go to the next one here. I want to write a implementation. This is a, if it is a standard object, if the relation between the two objects is a standard, this is how we have written the SQL query. What if it is a custom relation? It is not created by the Salesforce, it is created by the user. The two objects are connected by a custom lookup field. Two objects are connected by a custom master detail field. Then in that case, how did you write a SQL query? List of parent. Sales underscore underscore R from select parent field 1, parent field 2, select child field 1, child field 2 from sales from parent. Select parent field 1, parent field 2, select child field 1, child field 2 from sales underscore underscore R from parent. Now, if you remember, we used to give lookup relation, master detail relation. If you are trying to create any lookup field or a master detail, everyone look at this. Listen here, everyone. If you remember, if you are trying to create a master detail or a lookup relation, student, new lookup look at this. We have a child relation name, right? Actually, this is what we are supposed to use. So by default, if the student is, if the object is child is student, the relationship name is going to be students. If we change it, what are the name we have given that we have to use? By default, it will come as plural form. If it is employee, we get employees, student, students. Okay, if we change it, whatever the name we have changed, that we have to use that. By default behavior is whatever the child object we have, the plural form of the child object is the relationship name. Whatever the child object we have taken, the plural form of the child object is going to be a relationship name. If you change this, whatever the name we are mentioning, that name underscore underscore R we have to give. Okay, boss. Are you clear? In case if you modify, 99.99% we don't touch it. In case if you modify it, that name we have to use it. Now let us take an example. Let us assume that you have account. Both of them are connected by a lookup relation. What are the fields we have? More amount transaction. Now write a SQL query to get all the accounts with the corresponding payments. Write a SQL query to get all the accounts with the corresponding payments. Write a SQL query to get all the accounts with the corresponding payments. Write a SQL query to get all the accounts with the corresponding payments. Write SQL query to get all the account records with the corresponding payments. Now, account is a standard, payment is a custom. Now we are not interested whether it is a standard object, whether it is a custom object. What we are interested is it standard relation or a custom relation? We are not interested whether a parent is a standard, child is a standard. We are interested whether both the objects are created by standard relation or custom relation. What we are interested is how these two objects are connected. We are not interested what are those two objects. I hope you are good. Write a query now. List of account. Name. Select ID, name, industry. Select mode, amount, transaction date from payments, underscore, underscore, or from account.
So the field name will be underscore, underscore, C, but the table name will be in underscore, underscore, R, is it?
Yeah. So now see, this is not the field name. This is about child object relationship name. The child object is payment. We have payments, underscore, underscore, R. It is not the name of the field. The child object, plural form, underscore, underscore, R.
Okay, yeah.
Now, next one. I have customer. I have a loan object. Sorry. So write a query to fetch all the customer with the corresponding loan records. Write a query to fetch all the customers with the corresponding loan records. Write a query to fetch all the customers with the corresponding loan records. Write a query to fetch all the customers with the corresponding loan records. If you create the relationship, it is a custom. If Salesforce has created the relationship between two objects, standard. Yeah, standard field or a custom field. Now, right, boss? So now did you list of customer? We are fetching parent to child. From parent object, we are getting the corresponding child data. From the parent object, we are getting the corresponding child data. and record with the corresponding cell data. Done, boss. Let us go to the next example. We are going to take a combination. Now look at this example, everyone. I hope everybody is good with that example. Let us go to the next example here. Now we have now look at this example. Name, phone, industry. Opportunities. Select subject, priority from whatever switching account, list of corresponding contacts, list of corresponding opportunities, list of corresponding cases. We can fetch multiple cell objects in a single SQL query. Account with a list of contact, list of opportunities, list of case. List of contacts, list of opportunities, list of case. Now I want to display the data here. Listen carefully, boss. Page block. Page block table value equal to list of accounts with a variable A. A is referring to what? One account. A is referring to what? One account. Then I give apex column value equal to a dot name, account name, apex column value equal to a dot industry, account name, account industry. Right. Now every account will have what? Group of Every account will have a group of contacts. Account may have group of contacts. So I have taken a apex column. Data table value equal to a dot contacts. Now what is the relation we have used? Contacts. So a dot contacts will give you list of contacts of the account. Then we had next column. letter value equal to opportunities. Then I had repeat or data list. A dot opportunities. Try to understand this point carefully. We are going to write a lot of logics on this. C dot name. This is how I do. So A invalid field of opportunities. A dot contacts. A dot opportunities. Whatever the relation I have used there. From contacts. From contacts. From opportunities. This is how we got it. Account with the list of contacts with the list of opportunities. Are you clear about this? Right, boss? Am I clear? In a single SQL query, I can get multiple child data. Right? Okay. Now, look at the requirements what we are going to form. I feel everybody has followed this SQL query. Okay. Now, try to get this requirement. Try to understand. Write a SQL query to fetch all the accounts with the corresponding contact records fetch all the contacts phone number put them in separate list. Write a SQL query to fetch write this. Then what is your requirement? Take one by one account. How do you take one by one account? Account A. Account A accounts. Then conlist dot add all A dot contacts. But before adding the A dot contacts, check if A dot contacts dot size greater than, if the account has any contacts, add them to the list. It is not necessary that every account will have a contacts. A is one account. That account contacts are A dot contacts. For every account, there is a list of contact, list of opportunities. Right. So if that account has any contacts, then add them to the list. If the account has any contacts, add them to the list. Is that was clear for everyone? The statement was clear for everyone. People are busy in copying. Go to the next one. Go to the next one and create. Okay, fine. Done. Okay. Do the next example. Then what I ask you to do, fetch the opportunity amount, put them in a separate list. Then how you are going to take for for account A, account. Select. Read source. This is what we got. Now go ahead. Then you are supposed to take one by one contact. list of contacts. Then take one by one contacts from the list of accounts and check whether lead source is web. If the lead source is web, put them in a separate list. How do you take one by one contact? For account A, for account A accounts, then for contact C, A dot if C dot lead source equal to web. If the C dot lead source equal to web, if C dot lead source equal to web, then add to the con list. Take one by one contact. Verify whether lead source equal to web. If the lead source equal to web, put them in a separate list. Take one by one contact. Check whether lead source equal to web. If the lead source equal to web, put them in a separate list. Is there was clear for everyone? Right, boss? Okay. Let us take the next one. List of opportunities. If close opportunity close date is today, put their write a SQL query to fetch accounts with all that, fetch all the accounts with the list of opportunities. If opportunity close date is today, then put their amount in a separate list. I hope everybody has followed these queries. Everyone is good with this query format, boss. Any query from your end? Everybody is able to write these queries? Right. Run a SQL to fetch all the accounts with the list of opportunities. If opportunity close date is today, then put their amount in a separate list. Right. How did you do that? Then what we are doing here? List of account. Account. So I want the opportunity amount to be separate. If you want the amount to be separate, then how do you take it? For account A, accounts. One by one account we are taking. For every account we are taking, opportunity. Account A, list of accounts, one account we are taking. For every account we have a group of opportunities we have verified, and I told if opportunity close date equal to system dot today. If opportunity close date equal to system dot today, then we are going to put right amount. So fine. Now everyone is comfortable with the topics what we have done. People are comfortable in writing the logics here. Right? Right, boss? So whatever the topics we have done, you are comfortable with this? Right? Respond. Always. Yes or no, anyone? Right. People are comfortable with the format of list, set, map, wrapper. We are writing the SQL queries. Is that was clear for everyone? Right. Now, what you are supposed to do is this parenthetical SQL query you have to convert into wrapper class. Now, create a wrapper class with account record, list of contact, list of opportunity. Write a SQL query, get the data, put it in a wrapper, display it. Right? I hope you are good. People are comfortable with this concepts here. Right, boss? People are comfortable. Very horrible people, boss. That's all from my end for the day. We'll continue tomorrow.
Satish?
Yes.
Satish, here we have to get the contact also, right? From opportunity table before using it.
We can get it.
Okay, can we use without getting it? Written by that.
Come again?
Can we use without getting that from select?
No. First, you are supposed to get it, then put them in
there. But in our query, there is no select today's date, I mean, close date.
See, now the point is, if you already have a list of records like this, how to get the data is the question mark. Now, there is a better way of writing the getting the data. Now here I am not giving the example to get the write a better query. Here my requirement was, if you are getting a parent child data like this, how do you scrutinize and write a logic is the question mark. If you want only today record, you can straight away give it here, right? The straight away query, right? But my intention was to tell you that you have to use some logic. If data is given like this, how to use a logics. I'm insisting on writing a logic here. Okay. Right, boss. So that's all from my end.
Hello, Satish.
Yeah.
Sir, what we'll be covering in next 2 days? I will not be able to attend classes.
Child to parent, then some indexing concepts, aggregate results.
Okay, Satish. Thank you.
You are supposed to try it. You are supposed to try it. You are supposed to try it. Everything if I write, what you will try? Try from your end first. I give a requirement, I am asking you to practice something. Just try it. Okay. Then stuck up, come to me. I'll help you out. I'll not write the code. Okay.